I'm telling you, Uchu, I have never heard of any...
What are you two up to?
Uchu and I are swapping scar stories.
Jonah tells me you have a few yourself.
No great tales with mine, just me being careless.
I got this one here from my cousin, Eli.
Your cousin gave you that? And are you still speaking?
Well, it wasn't my cousin exactly. It was a worm that I...
Perhaps I had to have been there.
Yeah, probably. So what about you? That one looks like it's got a good story to go with it. What happened?
A very ancient recipe.
If my recipes did that, I think I'd rather starve.
It is not that kind of recipe. This one was for a weapon.
Ah, what sort of weapon?
The White Breath. It is a poison found deep in the wilderness. Its effects would double our numbers without adding a single life. Just the thing the Rebellion needs to push back Amaru and his army.
So what happened?
I failed.
You couldn't find it?
No, my friend. I was not worthy. To master the recipe of the White Breath, you must traverse the Path of Fear. It is a treacherous place filled with terrible demons.
You believe the White Breath could save rebel lives?
Many, but that hope is lost now. I cannot go back. It is too dangerous.
What if I went with you? We could get the recipe for the White Breath together.
I appreciate your offer, Lara, but the Path of Fear must be taken alone.
Then I'll go.
I cannot ask you to do that.
You didn't. I'm offering.
No.
Lara, maybe this isn't something you
Uchu,
should...
I can help. Please, let me.
Take the passage through the water beneath this cave. It will lead you to the wilderness. From there, you're on your own.
This can't be the path of fear. I must have... Hello? Can you hear me?
Why can't you be happy with what you have?
Mom!
God, help me! Please!
Jonah! Jonah!
I can't breathe out here! Happen to me, Laura.
Jonah! Jonah!
Why did you bring me here, Laura? Why would you do this to me? Don't let this happen to me, Laura.
I've got you, Jonah. Please, please, hang on. Come on, don't be dead, please. Jonah, come on! Come on, Jonah!
You know what to do.
I'm not in pain.
Selfish brat! Their pain, not yours! All the lives you've destroyed, and so many more to come. You destroy everyone you touch. Little cancer, little death!
No, I wouldn't. They're my friends, they're all...
Dead or doomed, you know it, feel it. You're a black thumb, Lara. Incapable of keeping life. First your mother. Then your father, and now your friends!
No!
Hey, it's me, it's Jonah. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, thank God. She made it. She's okay.
Well done, Lara. You've proven yourself worthy. Now you must enter the Valley of the Monkey Gods and retrieve the White Breath.
The Monkey Gods? You mean the twins, Hunahan and Hunchevin?
Yes. It is believed they authored the recipe for the White Breath as a means of revenge against the brothers who transformed them.
Hunahan and Hunchevin must have traveled through here when they were banished from Paititi. No one's been through here in centuries. Massive fault line. Must have fractured centuries ago. A perfect place to hide if you wanted to disappear like the Monkey Twins did.
Hmph!
This place is falling apart. Being exposed on the cliffsides like this. I'm amazed any of it's still here. Hun and Hun Chevin. Those statues are enormous. This has to be a gate to something. This looks like a wooden turbine. It seems to be jammed. What does this turbine power, I wonder? There's no way forward. That did it. The turbine must be using the valley wind to power some sort of instrument. Thank you. Why would Hunanan and Hunchevan build this place? Are gone. Thank you.
Lara, it's good to see you again.
You too, Uchu. How are the preparations going for Etsli's coronation?
Not well, sadly. Shortly after you left Paititi, a group of hunters pulled Zan's body from the wilderness.
Zan, was he one of the men you sent out?
To retrieve the champion's bow, yes. Lara, I hate to ask you, but...
But would I go and get the champion's bow?
It's a lot to ask. This is the most difficult of the items to retrieve. Zan was one of our best.
May I ask what makes this bow so special?
Queen Unaratu's ancestors carved it from the first Seiba tree to grow in the wilderness outside the city. It has been handed down through generations. She bestowed it upon Sairi, Etsli's father, on their wedding day. It joins the two families together, but it was lost many years ago, taken by the Nahual.
The Nahual? That's someone who has the power to transform into an animal, right?
Yes. This one stalks the jungle outside the city. Envious, it tricks Sairi into giving it the bow. Etsli is the rightful heir of the champion's bow. Without it, he cannot be king.
Okay, point the way.
Thank you. You will find the entrance directly across from here, up the shore of the river.
Don't worry, I'll do my best to get the bow.
Welcome back. Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
She found it.
Here, the white breath.
Strange. Such a small thing can hold such great power.
I hope it gives the rebellion the advantage it needs over Amaru and his cult.
I think we both know that it will.
Uchu, I still think you owe us a story. Because I'm trying to put that scar and a recipe in the same equation.
I don't really think there's anything to tell.